It's Tuesday the 30th of December, broadcasting from Urbis in the heart of Greater Manchester. This is Channel M's Lunchtime News, and these are today's headlines. 12th time lucky, a Bolton man finally gets his life-saving lung transplant.
So miracles happen, don't they? On Christmas Day. They do. It's brilliant, and it's thank you to the donors, isn't it?
Also this lunchtime, think before you phone. A warning, unnecessary 999 calls could put lives at risk this new year.
A young man phoned up saying that his girlfriend was addicted to Facebook and he wanted some advice on how he could deal with that.
Plus, the champion turkey breeder at the age of six, whose birds are gobbling their way past the competition.
At first I thought I weren't going to win, but then I did. We took the trophies home to put them on my shelf.
Good afternoon. First this lunchtime, there's a warning. Lives could be put at risk this new year by people misusing the 999 service here in Greater Manchester. Police getting ready for one of their busiest nights of the year are worried the numbers being called unnecessarily. Here's Channel M's Nina Warhurst.
Hello, police emergency. OK, what is the emergency, please?
In the space of just 6 hours over New Year, it's thought call handlers like these at Greater Manchester Police will receive around 3,000 calls. Now, based on previous experience, it's estimated that 75% of them will be unnecessary.
The calls were a gentleman phoned up this week saying that he'd ordered a pizza, and he'd ordered the pizza without mushroom, and he'd got the pizza delivered to him with mushroom. Now, appreciating that that might be important in this gentleman's life, what I have to say is that we, the police, don't consider that to be a true emergency. Another example would be a young man phoned up saying that his girlfriend was addicted to Facebook and he wanted some advice on how he could deal with that.
These examples might seem funny, but the reality isn't just frustrating, but dangerous.
A true emergency could be somebody having been stabbed, having been assaulted, that needs medical attention immediately. We need to protect a crime scene. Or it could be a missing from home child whose parents are very distressed. And if my call handlers are actually dealing with a call that is an inappropriate one, time is wasted and it's precious time.
Well, the last call I've just taken was actually what we call a thieves on, which was a lady reporting that she could see people breaking into the address opposite her. Obviously, it's very traumatic for her, but obviously it's a real emergency. We need to get officers there straight away.
And you're under a lot of pressure here as call handlers. How does it make you feel when you do see these hoax calls coming?
Oh, it can be really annoying because you just don't know what call's coming next, and obviously you just don't know, it could be tying up the line for a while, and you just want to get onto the next call, which could be a genuine emergency.
What would your message be for people over the New Year period who are thinking about dialing 999?
My message would be very simple, and that is just to think. Just to think what calls you would like the police, the ambulance and the fire service to be dealing with at this time. Would you want your family members to be waiting to be connected to a police officer whilst we're taking an inappropriate call, or would you like to make sure that in a true emergency we're responding appropriately and as quickly as possible?
Nina Warhurst, Channel M News.
A man has been left scarred for life in Crumpsall after armed robbers hit him in the face with an axe. Mohammed Yunus was in bed with his wife when four masked raiders broke through the kitchen window of his home on Brooklands Road. They then made off with two mobile phones and a gold chain. The 58-year-old has had to have surgery on a large gash that runs from his forehead, through his eye and down his cheek. Police are also looking for a man who fired a gun during an armed robbery just a few streets away in Greenhill Road. It happened in the early hours of yesterday morning. He threatened two men sitting in a car and then made off with their mobile phones and some cash. A man has been shot in the street in Oldham. It happened just after 11 o'clock on Monday as the 39-year-old was walking along South Hill Street in Glodwick. The bullet hit him in the chest, but his injuries are not thought to be life-threatening. The gunman escaped in a car. Stephen Gerrard's been charged by police investigating reports of a brawl outside a nightclub. The Liverpool footballer will appear in court next month, charged with assault and affray. Two other men from Liverpool have also been charged after a disturbance outside a late-night bar in Southport called the Lounge Inn. It's been closed since, and spots of blood can be seen through the windows with shards of broken glass. The venue's DJ, who's 34, was taken to hospital with injuries to his face. A desperately ill man from Bolton who's had his lung transplant cancelled 11 times has finally had the surgery he needs. Brian Maloney, who's 60, is now recovering in hospital, as Kevin Duffy's been finding out.
This mobile phone picture, through the window of an intensive care unit at Withenshaw Hospital, tells Hilary Grimshaw and her family that her partner Brian has been given the gift of life.
So miracles happen, don't they, on Christmas Day? They do. It's brilliant. And it's thank you to the donors, isn't it? Yeah.
Brian underwent a 9-hour lung transplant after being admitted to hospital on Christmas Day. 3 weeks before the operation, Brian spoke to Channel M.
You get to thinking, is this going to actually happen? Which does is very, very frightening. Very frightening to think that I might not get one. And I'm going downhill quite quickly.
So, touch wood, at the moment, everything seems positive, yeah? It's just, you feel like you've moved on. Excellent. You feel like you've moved on. I feel like I've had a weight lifted off my shoulders, and I think Brian does as well, yeah. And thank you to Withenshaw, thank you to the doctors and everybody, I mean, and obviously the donor. It's, we don't know who it is, but... just thank you, whoever it is. The transplant team and everybody have been wonderful. They really have, yeah.
Fantastic.
Yeah. You're frightened they're going to say, oh, I'm sorry, you're too ill, you can't have the operation. And that's the one worry we did have, that he might be getting too ill to have the operation. But, well said, brilliant Christmas, and what could be better?
Absolutely.
Although the road to complete recovery is still a long one, Brian has taken the most important step. Kevin Duffy for Channel M News.
Israel is promising it can carry on pounding Gaza for weeks as its airstrikes there move into a fourth day. Officials say they're determined to stamp out militant rocket attacks. More than 360 people have been killed since Saturday. The country's interior ministers rejected calls for a ceasefire. A further 150 Woolworths stores will close their doors later. Here in Greater Manchester, 5 will finish trading in Hyde, Urmston, Rochdale, Glossop and Rottenstall. Another 200 will shut on Friday, with the last locking up for the final time next Monday. It's come out that more than £300,000 of taxpayers' cash has been spent suing the designers of Manchester's Bee of the Bang sculpture. The 180-foot structure is the country's biggest public artwork, but now looks like ending up on the scrapyard. The city's council took legal action over a catalogue of errors, including one of the 7-foot spikes falling off and a further 9 having to be removed. A £1.7 million of court, £1.7 million out-of-court settlement was agreed last month. A baby whose life was saved by an email has now been given a clean bill of health by doctors. Madeline Robb from Stretford spotted that her friend's baby was suffering from eye cancer just by looking at a photograph.
There was something odd about the pictures. Her eye was reflecting a certain light, like a white glare.
Madeline Robb and her daughter Lily live thousands of miles away from her American friend Megan, but she spotted there was something wrong with her friend's daughter as soon as she saw this photograph.
I knew from reading something in a previous news article that it wasn't normal. So I went and looked it up online, and it did look to have all the indicators of cancer, a specific cancer.
Madeline met Megan online. They were pregnant at the same time and even gave birth on the same day. They shared advice and concerns over the internet. When this picture of Megan's daughter Rowan appeared in Madeline's inbox, she instantly recognised that the white reflection in her eye could be a sign of a rare form of cancer.
I contacted her immediately. She was quite concerned, obviously, and went straight to the doctor. Within a few hours, they had determined that she did, in fact, have cancer.
Doctors said Rowan had a large tumour in her eye, a telltale sign being a white shadow caused by flash photography. She's now undergone surgery to remove the eye, but doctors say she is free from cancer, which wasn't even picked up by a doctor as part of a 9-month checkup. Not surprisingly, Rowan's parents are extremely grateful.
You know, your child's life is at risk, and to have someone on the other side of the world pointed out when your own doctor can't is quite an incredible experience.
Madeline says one day she hopes to meet face-to-face her friend and her daughter, whose life Madeline has saved. Andy Buckley, Channel M News.
Manchester's outdoor ice rink is going to stay open for another 3 weeks. More than 20,000 people have used the spinning field attraction since it opened a month ago. It was due to close on Sunday. Time now for a check on the day's sports headlines. Here's Sam Goodman.
Thank you, James. Well, non-league side Drawsden are still unsure whether they'll be reinstated into the FA Cup. The Bloods were kicked out of the competition yesterday for fielding an ineligible player against Chesterfield in the second round. The club are making an appeal today, with a decision being made tomorrow. The third round tie against Ipswich is set to be played on Saturday, and currently it'll be Chesterfield who'll be playing in the match. Drawsden chairman Dave Pace doesn't blame the League Two side for the decision made by the FA yesterday.
Really blame Chesterfield. I mean, they're obviously upset because we beat them, aren't they? You know, I mean, they're obviously bound to be upset because non-league sides beat them. They can't beat us over four and a half games. And to clutch at a scraw like this is unbelievable, to be honest. But no, I don't really blame him, really. I mean, I suppose if someone brought it to my attention, I'd do exactly the same. But, I mean, we are talking about football. We're not talking about, you know, we're not talking about banking. We're not talking about, you know, secretary. We're not talking about anything. We're talking about football. The be-all and end-all is what the FA Cup's all about, and that's about football. That's about the little minnows trying to make an upset, cut upsets, which we did. Not once, not twice. You know, a few times now. You know, we've had four attempts to beat us, we haven't done. Yet, there has been an administrative error, I agree, but not enough to kick us out of the competition.
Manchester United left it until the 69th minute to see off Middlesbrough last night at Old Trafford. Dimitar Berbatov scored from close range in what was a tricky game for the Reds. They are now 7 points behind league leaders Liverpool with two games in hand. Up next for United in the league is Chelsea a week on Sunday. Manchester City star Robinho feels that the threat of getting the axe could be the reason for the Blues' inconsistent form. The Brazilian says that constant rumours of people leaving in January has in some way damaged the squad. The latest rumour has linked West Ham players Craig Bellamy and Scott Parker with a move to Eastlands. In League Two, Stockport County's match against Leeds on Sunday saw the biggest third division attendance at Edgeley Park since 1968, with over 10,000 fans turning out for County. More bizarrely, the previous highest attendance was exactly 40 years ago to the day when they beat Southport 3-0. And 2 days earlier on Friday, Sale Sharks had a sold-out crowd for their victory over the London Wasps. Finally, Altrincham are hoping for a bumper crowd at Moss Lane on New Year's Day for the Cheshire Derby match with Northwich Victoria. Altrincham are offering fans from Premier League and Football League clubs a reduced admission for just £5 for the 3 o'clock kickoff. That's all from me for now. We'll have more later on in our early evening news. Back to James.
Thanks very much, Sam. Still to come between now and 1 o'clock, more of the day's main headlines and find out why it's not so much cold turkey as gold turkey for a schoolboy whose birds are winning medals.
Tell me how you felt when you realised that you'd won with your turkeys.
I felt very happy. And the golden side.
And don't you think you're a bit young for this?
No.
Welcome back to Channel M's Lunchtime News with all the day's top stories from Greater Manchester between 12 and 1 o'clock. Our reports are always online as well at channelm.co.uk. On there right now, the investigation into the death of a man who fell from a burning flat and a series of reports paying tribute to the actress Kathy Staff, whose funeral was held in Duckinfield last week. That's at channelm.co.uk. Let's check some more of the day's top stories now. And patients will soon be able to log on and leave comments about their appointments with GPs on the NHS website. Messages about their experiences at different practices will be allowed, but they won't be able to comment on individual doctors. The idea is supposed to help improve standards. Education officials in Rochdale are planning a New Year crackdown on children skipping school. 60 youngsters were found missing lessons in just one day of checks in the town centre. Some said they were Christmas shopping, while others claimed they were on lunch breaks. Fines are being threatened for parents who don't get their children to school. The North West Regional Development Agency is being criticised for splashing out almost £90,000 on entertaining politicians. It ran up the tab on things like wine, food and hotels during this year's three main party conferences. The agency's funded through taxpayers' cash and spent more than £30,000 more than any of the eight others in the country. The Taxpayers' Alliance is calling it a misuse of public funds. Let's take a look at the entertainment news now, which comes from Robert Hodgson and Steph Elmore's country retreat in Cheshire.
It's New Year's Eve, Steph, nearly New Year's Eve.
All right, calm down. Well, with all the drinking and eating we've been doing this year, I've got quite a good idea for a New Year's resolution for you.
It's cheeky.
Mind you, I've made my New Year's resolution. I have promised to be much nicer to our estate staff.
Yeah, whatever.
Alright. What about you? You haven't made up your mind yet.
Yeah, to find a new co-presenter.
I'm sorry.
Thank you. But here are some ideas of what you want to be doing for New Year's resolution.
New Year's resolution, what's my name? I've got to make one. What have I got to do in New Year?
I don't know.
Give up smoking.
Give up smoking.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Don't spend as much.
I would say probably to be happier, probably not work so hard, and probably just relax a bit more next year.
I don't ever make New Year resolutions.
To be more tolerant.
Very much doubt it, because I break every one I make.
What about yourself? You making New Year's resolutions?
Probably to try and save some money, but I very much doubt it'll work, but might as well make it and break it, I suppose.
Well, you're bound to get some ideas from that lot.
Absolutely.
Brilliant stuff. Now, look, we've got to say thank you to Tatton Mansion because they let us come and film all these links in their beautiful Christmas extravaganza. Unfortunately, we couldn't let cameras into City Life Towers. The security for me and Steph is much too tight.
Yeah.
Now, New Year.
New Year. Well, we do have some great ideas for you what to do at New Year's Eve, and it's going to be accompanied by four very hot, good-looking men. It is, of course, Take That.
Today this could be the greatest day of our lives. Today this could be the greatest day of our lives.
Now, he might only be six, but George Brearley from Duckinfield's already making a name for himself in the world of turkey breeding. His champion birds are becoming the envy of farmers who've been doing the same thing for decades. Here's Georgia Calvin-Smith.
George Brearley may be only six, but he's already a big hit with the birds. Turkeys, that is.
But what I like about turkeys is the wing, and it's the same with the chickens.
George breeds champion birds on an allotment in Duckinfield and earlier this month won the Juvenile Best in Show Award at a national poultry competition. Taking pride of place in his collection is a Norfolk black turkey that weighs almost as much as he does. It was named Show Champion.
At first I thought I weren't going to win, but then I did. When we go home, we take the trophies home to put them on my shelf.
And how many trophies do you have now?
I don't know, because I've won that many.
George only started showing his turkeys competitively about a year ago, and he's already got his eye on more poultry prizes. He looks after more than 20 birds, and every morning gets up early, lets them out of their pens, and on the way home from school, feeds them and puts them away for the night.
I think he gets a good understanding of animals in general, the caring for animals, the feeding, hatching the eggs. He enjoys doing the incubator at school.
George has been raising turkeys since he was just 3 years old. And as well as having a run of success at national poultry shows with his big birds, he's also pecked up a number of awards with his chickens. What's your favourite chicken?
Frizzle. It's the curly.
So that's a winning chicken, is it?
Yeah, and it always wins. Never stops.
This year at the National Show, we got champion Frizzle out of a class of 40 birds, which was quite an achievement, really.
So George is getting his hands on some pretty precious stock early on in his career.
Yeah, yeah, we have got some good breeding birds now, and hopefully we can go on from strength to strength.
George doesn't get broody over his birds. He doesn't give them names and has no qualms about having a turkey on his table when the time is right. What did you do at Christmas? Did you eat a turkey?
Yeah.
Where did that come from?
Here.
You ate one of your own turkeys for Christmas? With that business-like attitude, little George will no doubt be getting more feathers to his cap in the future. Georgia Calvin Smith, Channel M News.
Time now to take a look at the lunchtime weather. Well, it's been a freezing cold morning across Greater Manchester. Still feeling cold now as well. There's been a lot of frost and ice around, mainly cloudy as well. Just the occasional short, bright spell here and there through the day. There could be some light showers here and there as well. Temperatures hovering around freezing point, possibly just 1 or 2 degrees higher, if at all. If we look at the cloud map coming up as well, you can see that the morning was very overcast right across Greater Manchester, shown by the darker shading here. The brighter spells will break out, though, for a time during the afternoon, but those clearer skies won't last long, and it'll cloud over as we move into the late afternoon and evening and through tonight, getting misty and foggy overnight as well. The outlook for the rest of the week, the main headline is it's going to be very cold, temperatures down to -5 tonight, wrap up warm if you're going out. Thicker cloud tomorrow, a few more crisp, bright spells for New Year's Day and Friday, but again, still feeling bitterly cold, lows down to -4. You're watching Channel M's Lunchtime News. Our main headlines this afternoon. A man from Bolton has finally been given the life-saving lung transplant he needs after the operation had been cancelled 11 times. 60-year-old Brian Maloney got the call he'd been waiting for shortly after finishing his Christmas dinner. He's now recovering. Stephen Gerrard has been charged with assault and affray after reports of a brawl outside a nightclub in Southport. The England and Liverpool footballer is due to appear in court next month, accused over an attack that left a DJ from the late-night bar needing hospital treatment for facial injuries. Police are looking for armed raiders in Crumpsall after a burglary that left a man scarred for life. The victim, Mohammed Yunus, was hit in the face with an axe and needed surgery for a gash from his forehead through his eye and down his cheek. We'll have more on those stories in our early evening news later with Claire Fallon. But that's it from me for now. We're back next Monday from 12 noon. Have a very good and happy new year. Bye-bye for now.